Okay, hello everyone, welcome back to Suikoden 2. I am SIMSteven, also known as Master Fenrel. And, looks like today we'll be finishing this long LP. And, well, we just started off at the final save point in La Renoir Castle. And, I'm pretty sure in a room or two we'll be fighting the final boss. So, one last look at my party before we head inside. A lot of us are level 60. Actually, we're all level 60 or above. And you might guess I tend to focus on spellcasters. Which is why I have all these people in. Well, George is like the odd man out just because he's so awesome. Anywho, looks like we're finally in the throne room of the castle. And keep going up and up and up. We should encounter the final challenge that stands before us, and complete victory. Oddly enough, it's not Jowy. It's Leon Silversberg, who apparently survived the fire in the forest before, but he's standing above the beast rune, which is on the floor right there. Were you? I never meant for this to happen, but I must admit, I'm impressed you made here. Well, this is the end. Beast rune that Luca Blight left. Its demonic incarnation is here. The man that fed on the blood and souls of you citizens. It's all I could do just to keep it sealed here. It was Luca's plan all along to release this beast on the world. This is your final test. Can you win this time, Ryu? Apparently, he's committing suicide to release the beast.
Yeah.
And there we go. That is the fight with the Beast Rune. And before we continue on, yes, we do gain levels. But more importantly, one thing I want to say about the fight, go for the legs. I forget which leg has this ability, but one of the legs has the ability to revive the other parts. And I think with full health. So that's what I was going after, both the right and left legs, so that when they went down around in the same turn. And I was just kind of spreading the damage out between all the party parts in general with attack all spells like Tengar's Rage Rune, like the attack all spells with the Wind Rune that Sierra was using. I was holding off on using spells like Judgment from Tyr's Soul Eater, and of course, Forgiver's Sign from Ryu. But I was primarily focused on the legs, just because I knew that one of them would revive the others. But I love that fight. Just the way everything looks. And it's one of the reasons why I say it's boring to use runes that just boost your physical attackers to do massive damage. Because I love how things look if you are in a really cinematic fight like that. With the ambient, or not really ambient, but the misty, surreal background that the fight had. It just makes the spell effects look so much more awesome, especially when you got that giant-ass two-headed wolf. Just the lovely sprite art from that thing. Just whenever it casts a spell or anything, it's just like, it looks awesome. Anywho, moving on to the final ending, and yes, we've maxed out on Potch as we were going through the Runwa castle itself. So we've done it. We've defeated all of Highland. I don't know exactly where Leon went. Potentially he died there, sacrificed his own life to the Beast Rune to revive it, and, well, the beast itself. Either way, we find the throne room and Jowy's cloak or coat or whatever it was that he was wearing the whole time. I guess it was a coat. It was a lot less of a coat or a cloak than whatever, because it didn't really have anything trailing behind, kind of like what George is wearing. But either way, wow, this is the throne room. This is strange. The king is nowhere to be seen. And even though he's a silent protagonist, especially since we played through the first game, all potential party members have a potential to say something here at the final cutscene. And Tyr breaks his silent protagonist role and actually says, "Is it collapsing? Be out for you. We must survive." You're right. We'll find Jowy eventually, potentially. Right, let's go. I won't let you die, don't worry. There goes George being the strong protector type once again. And, well, we're running out of here. Time to get the hell out of Dodge. By the way, why is it always gotta be that whenever you defeat the final boss, the castle that you're in collapses? Did the same thing in Suikoden 1, too. Then again, it was a battle of true runes in that fight there. With or without Tyr Mikdal, there were at least two runes in that fight, the Beast Rune and the Bright Shield Rune. Anyways, we're cutting it kind of close, but thankfully, Victor and Flick aren't sacrificing themselves this time. No, I'll hold them off while you escape kind of deal from the first game that kind of left a lot of loose threads from the first game. And it wasn't until this game came out that we realized, oh, they made it out. They survived. But yeah, either way, Lord Ryu, you can't mean. Don't even say that as a joke. He'll come back. I know it. can't die. He's going to bring priests to this land. He just can't die. Look. Yeah, there we are. Safe and sound for once. And everyone's gathering around. Ryu. 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 I was worried about you, Ryu. Welcome back, Ryu. That's the Ryu I know. You're blessed with good luck in combat. Ryu, thank the gods. You did it. You really came back, Ryu. Terrific. Great. And success. Now, where's that happy ending? Well, once again, we must have collapsed after all that was over. Or maybe it's just been a few days or something, or a week, or I don't know. Maybe some time has passed since the Highland Castle has fallen. Anyway, good morning, Ryu. Hey, come on, get up. Representative Jeremakai from Two River and Mayor Gustav from Tinto are waiting for you in the Great Hall. Come on, hurry, hurry. The war may be over, but there's still lots of things to be done. Got a whole new country to create, right? Well, who knows about the prospect of that. Alright, everyone's in the Great Hall. What are you doing here? Yeah, no, what's this? Yeah, apparently, at random, sometimes Hoi can be in our room, probably stealing some shit or whatever, I don't know. Either way, castle's kind of back to normal, I guess? I guess we could talk to a few people here and there. And, well, before we begin, now that the final battle is over. Oh, by the way, most active party member is me! What a quinky dink. I want to talk to a few people here and there. And I don't know if I've even shown that terrace off before in the past, but I believe whoever's in that statue is the one who's the most active party member. Or the VIP of all of us. I'm guessing it's based on who gets the most kills in battle. Not 100% sure. I do want to talk to at least a few people. Not someone like Miss Merger who only goes, But I do want to talk to a couple of people just to see if there's any new dialogue from the people who are here in the castle, I guess. That's going to be coming. Yeah, they're all saying new things. I don't know exactly if I'm going to go around and talk to everyone like I did back when Nanami died. Because we've got a little bit of post-game to do, and speaking of which, I was actually talking about this in previous episodes, but something I gotta show before we even get close to that save crystal outside the Great Hall is that if you try to change your party, or you just leave entirely, you cannot change your party. And I want to make sure you know that. Because when you're in the post-game, Ryu is basically on his own. Yo, Ryu, where are you going? Ryu, there's a great power within you. I don't mean that rune stuck in your hand either. Taking a great burden on your back thus far, and you have a duty to fulfill it to the end. People who died in the war, the people who survived... Let him go, Flick. It's necessary, that is. But Ryu, don't forget, you always got a home here. So, I think I might have triggered something unexpectedly by walking past those two. But the part I wanted to show is that if you try to change your party, once you're in the postgame, you cannot... Yeah, I went to one of the nearby cities to restock on our supply of whiskey. So yeah, we can't change our party at all because Leona isn't here. Alright, well... I guess not everybody has something new to say. Finally took care of that bloodsucking neckler. What should I do now? Amada? Yeah, not everybody has something new to say, I guess. I do want to point out, though, that just wanted to make sure, you know, once you beat the Beast Druid and achieve the ending of the game. Ryu's basically on his own, but you can explore the world completely if you want to. So there are a few things we can do. I am going to save my game, however, because I did make a backup before fighting the Beast Room. And if you want to do that too, go ahead. That way you'll be able to explore the world before with a full party and just, you know, dink around, do whatever you want to. Or you can explore the post-game. So yes, you can actually save once you've beaten the final boss of the game.